Where?
The hole. What kind of hole? It would be great if you could explain it to me in much more detail. Oh, I wasn't making a perverted joke or anything. It's really not a perverted joke. I'm serious.
Repeating yourself just makes it even more suspicious.
Yes, it does.
Now then, Hajime, will you battle against me?
Over a hole? Sure. Let's get ready to rumble! Find out. What does he mean, battle? It sounds like he's enjoying a game or something. Damn it! There's no way I'm gonna lose against somebody like him. Rebuttal showdown. Okay. Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Did you forget what Kazuichi said earlier? He said the hall was too dark to see the office. The light from the stove that you mentioned. It contradicts his testimony. Or are you intentionally doubting his testimony?
Assuming the portable stove was used as a light source contradicts Kazuichi's testimony. I don't think what Kazuichi said is wrong. I guess for now I should offer a rebuttal.
Did you forget what Kazuichi said earlier?
Oh,
he said the hall was too dark to see the office. The light from the stove that you mentioned. It contradicts his testimony. Or are you intentionally doubting his testimony? Did you forget what Kazuichi said earlier? He said the hall was too dark to see the office. The light from the stove that you mentioned. It contradicts his testimony. Or are you intentionally doubting his testimony?
Advance.
Okay, I doubt what Kazuichi said. What are you trying to say?
The reason Kazuichi couldn't see the was because the hallway was dark. So if a light was shining in such a dark hallway, wouldn't Kazuichi have seen it?
No, the
After
fire
all,
doors.
He was walking near the hallway, right?
So the fire doors were tricked.
The reason Kazuichi couldn't see the up was because the hallway was dark. So if a light was shining in such a dark hallway, wouldn't Kazuichi have seen it?
No.
Allow me to cut through those words.
So then Taro Taro was isolated from the main group and
did you forget?
Use his voice
you just
to make it sound like he had gotten in there.
Huh? What are you talking about?
There should have been a wall that blocked light.
Now, again, I don't really have fire doors where I live, at least any building I've ever been in. So I don't know if a blackout actually trips him automatically, because I imagine for a fire, it would trip it. But I don't know why a blackout, it would trip.
I'm talking about the fire door in the hallway. If you close it, it would form a perfect wall in the hallway.
Unless it was intentionally closed. Ah, that could be it too. Yeah. So Taro Taro closed those doors, then grabbed the portable stove. That way, nobody could see what he was doing.
Plus, the hallway rounds a corner just beyond the fire door. So even if there was a small gap in the door, as long as they passed the corner, the light still wouldn't peek out.
I see. To actually notice the fire door. Just as expected of the ultimate... Oh, you still don't remember your talent, do you?
But I got a funny feeling you know what it is, you asshole. You want to explain? Want to tell the classroom, please?
Who cares about that right now?
Nagito, ultimate what are you plotting?
Wait, are we like
for
the ultimate observant student?
Not the killer. You are quite nosy.
You sound so scary. If you're that angry, why don't you take a deep breath?
You sure like to piss us off. How about I shut your fucking mouth for you?
Like,
hey,
every time he drops an F-bomb, take a shot,
fight,
chat, whatever you're
but
drinking.
But I won't allow
Hopefully
a burly
alcohol.
Brawl that might offend people. More importantly, can you hurry up and decide who's the blackened already? Time runs out when I get bored.
Fine, I get it. You're telling me to pass the torch, right?
Pass the torch?
We're going to ask the real killer, not an imposter like me, to show themselves.
You're obviously the killer, right?
If Life is strange I all am, over again.
I really don't mind. Ella. Whatever conclusion you ultimates arrive at, I will accept it. No matter what it is.
So, you're telling me to call out the real killer? Even though I really don't know what I'm gonna condemn that person, but there's no other way, right? The person who used the hallway's fire doors cover, used the portable stove to move in the dark, and stuck under the floorboards to stab Byakuya. Death using the glowing paint as a mark. But the only killer I can think of is... You and only you.
Taro, Taro!
You're the only one! Taro, Taro. Could it be you?
Huh? What? What are you talking about?
Taro, Taro's the killer? Is that true?
What are you talking about? There's no way!
Of course, that's simply my assumption. So if you have an objection, please speak freely.
That would be a really good time.
Objection or not, why am I being treated like the killer?
What led to that conclusion? Well, Taro Taro had made an effort to say that his stoves ran only on electricity, which was a weird thing, especially since he somehow ignored the portable stove and saying that ran on electricity as well, or at least he implied that it did. He also seemed to be kind of shocked that we took account of the fact that we're missing one skewer. He was like, oh, that was weird. We also heard his voice in the dining hall, which is strange because that could almost be more of him trying to have an alibi while stabbing somebody to death. And the fact that he was the only one closest to the storage room at the time. He can make the distance clean, get underneath, and be in position the whole time. So, yeah. So as to motive, before the trial, when they were talking about like, what might have happened over a couple like year or so, that the missing memories that you have, I think it's gonna be as dumb as like maybe he got lucky, or he's hoping he got lucky and got a booty call, and since he can't remember said booty call, he wants that memory of the booty call back, and he is willing to kill for the booty memory. Yeah,
because the portable stove used in the murder came from the kitchen.
That's it? That's the only reason you're treating me like a killer? Isn't that a little drastic? You're cruel. Cruel. Too cruel.
Taro Taro. That attitude is so not like you. For the ultimate cook to get so upset.
Call me chef.
If you fall to aspersions like this, who will be there to support the future of the culinary arts?
The future of the culinary arts?
That's right. For the future of the culinary arts, you must face this and fight it fair and square.
You're right. Yeah, that's totally right.
So what's an aspersion anyway? Is it yummy?
I'll be honest, I don't know that word.
Did you know asbestos is yummy too? You should try some later.
Okay. If nobody kills Hayoko, I will do it! I will take him out.
Nagito, why are you interfering?
Actually, now that I think about it. No, that would only apply to Blackout. Maybe Taro Taro had initially thought to kill Byakuya, but saw it as an opportunity. Maybe he was just aiming to check under the floorboards for other things? Pervy things? And then realize, oh, Byakuya's here. And Nagito tried to take a shot, or at least he saw somebody struggling with Byakuya and then took that opportunity. But then at the same time, why would you bring a skewer with you? Unless you were hoping to use that as a way to move things aside. What started out as a potentially pervy mission has led into murder most foul. And apparently, if I'm right with this, Tarotaro is a fine line between, well, a sexual predator or a murderer. So, yeah. Also, Matt Morning.
Let's assume that the killer used a light, and that they used the fire door to mask that light, and that they moved to the storage room and snuck under the floorboards. Then what? It's dark under the floorboards too. So how would they be able to stab Byakuya? You're not gonna say they shined the light on Byakuya, right? The plan would have been ruined if he noticed.
That's right. What do you think about that?
There's no way you can answer, right? You personally haven't investigated what's beneath the floorboards.
Because you wouldn't allow me to check the boxes in the storage room to see if there was an access point to the floorboards. You intentionally, restrained my arms from being able to do anything. Even though, when we left Nagito, the game still wouldn't allow me to check on it. Which is kind of a bummer.
If that's the case, then Gundam should know. He actually went under the floorboards.
Yeah, actually, he would.
No. Unfortunately, there was nothing related to the incident under the floorboards.
There was nothing under there?
The only thing I found was a strange liquid shining in the darkness, near where Byakuya's blood was dripping.
Strange liquid shining in the darkness. What?
What? A shining liquid in the dark? That sounds super important!
If there was a shining mark like that, they would have been able to move to it in the dark, right?
Yes.
And in doing so, it might have been possible for them to use that mark to target the victim.
The victim was targeted by a mark. What was the mark? Well... Party dishes. Tarotaro use the sauce, maybe? No, how would you use that as a mark? I think it's possible.
Crap.
Sorry, okay, that was, I thought he might have poured one out. Something as a mark. Oh no. It wouldn't be that time. What, didn't she trip after the fact? Yeah, she tripped after that happened. So that should be unrelated, hopefully. I think. Maybe. Let's see here. And Irons already done that. Man, I don't think that's it, but. No, that's not. Okay, I was more than positive, like, that was after the fact. Okay. What's the Monokuma file say? Aside from that, the body was no other. That body was. Itching for something. What could be the shiny color? Oh, nope. I hit the wrong button. Okay, that's on me. I hit the wrong button. What could be used as a mark? Maybe the paint. It's gotta be. But would they acknowledge that as a option? It's got to be the knife because the paint has to be.
I can prove
there
it
we
with
go.
This.
Happy, hey buddy, morning. Also, happy birthday.
The mark you're talking about is the glowing here. Paint that was applied to the knife, right?
Which Akvi, did you get my message in Discord whether you wanted to celebrate the hour of your birthday at the end of today's stream or the beginning? Or the end of the afternoon stream. Did you have an idea on that?
By using the glowing paint as a target, They were able to judge where to stab, even in the dark.
Which, hold on. That means they had known about the knife and the paint there. So even if Byakuya was the one that actually brought it in, they used that as an area. At the end of the second? Okay, okay. Also, guys, if you didn't know, it is Acne's birthday today. Person.
They just struck the moment the glowing paint moved.
That would be the moment someone grabbed a hold of the knife.
So, the killer used the mark that I prepared for finding the knife as a mark for stabbing.
I see, I still don't trust that Nagito was the one that put the knife there. I really don't.
I see. That's why Byakuya got killed when he took the knife.
But if they were able to do that, wouldn't that mean the killer knew about Nagito's plan all along?
Well, Teru Teru!
Seriously? I don't know anything. Really?
Somebody's sweating up, chat.
At all.
Then can I ask everyone a question instead?
You again? Just stop already!
Let me guess.
Now. We should give everyone a fair opportunity to speak.
If Teru Teru is the killer, that would mean he went to the storage room during the blackout.
Yes.
And just what did Ibuki hear during the blackout?
Yeah, again, that's an alibi, though.
What the hell? What's going on here?
An attempt, I should say.
This is...
Ow!
Turn the damn lights on! I can't eat like this, you know?
You guys? Where are you? Wasn't the blackout just in the kitchen?
She heard Teru Teru's voice in the dining hall?
Doesn't that prove Teru Teru was in the dining hall during the blackout?
That's right! That's exactly it!
But Teru Teru was in the kitchen the moment the blackout occurred, right? So, why was he in the dining hall?
I thought the blackout was only in the kitchen, so I panicked and ran out of there.
You ran out of there in pitch black? Did you grab the portable stove?
Of course, the hallway was dark too, but somehow I managed to move along the wall toward everyone's voices.
Uh-huh.
Well, it's not that far to move along the wall from the kitchen to the dining hall.
That sounds fishy.
If I remember correctly, you can tell when a person is lying by licking their sweat. So, if you want, you should try licking me.
No way! You look greasy! But I heard Teru Teru's voice in the dining hall! Ibuki swears on her honor!
Ibuki talks in the third person.
That's right. Teru Teru was in the dining hall, not the storage room. Which means... he's not the killer.
Dum-dum, no, he could be under the floorboards at the same time.
Why do you want to keep falsely accusing me?
Okay, he hasn't flipped.
Like I want to blame you. I just...
you know.
You should be so proud of yourself, Hajime. You're just progressing toward the hope you believe in.
Okay, I don't want to beat the crap out of Nagato right about
Hajime,
now. Be really honest.
Show me more of your hope. Will that be enough to crush Teru Teru's hope?
You mean more as in find the guilty? Knife. Bloodstain under the table. Gaps in the floorboard.
Let me ask you again. Did you go to the storage room during the blackout?
There's no way I went to the storage room. I was somewhere totally different.
That sounds fishy.
I definitely heard Teru Teru's voice.
You did.
It's handsome, unlike his face.
Maybe it was recording or something?
No.
Nope, definitely a live voice.
Yeah?
Right, as long as I have her testimony. The fact that I was in the dining hall cannot be disputed.
Yeah, I call baloney. There's definitely a contradiction hidden with those remarks. Need to find it. Okay.
Let me ask you again. Did you go to the storage room during the blackout?
There's no way I went to the storage room.
It's gotta be after the floorboard, right?
I was somewhere totally different.
Yeah, you were. Under the floor.
I definitely heard Taro's voice. It's handsome. I like his face. Maybe it was recording or something? Nope, definitely a live voice.
Yeah?
Right, as long as I have her testimony. The fact that I was in the dining hall cannot... I'll shoot through that contradiction.
Just because we heard Taro's voice in the dining hall doesn't mean he was literally in the dining hall.
Huh? Why?
Remember the floor in the dining hall? It was full of gaps, right?
Trippable gaps, by the way.
So even if you shouted from under the floor, it should have sounded just like the voices in the dining hall.
And the conversation of Taro
so Taro brazenly shouted from under the floor to make us think he was in the dining hall. Is that true, Taro?
Hold on a second.
Can you explain this, Taro?
I told you to wait a second, ain't I?
Ain't a word, you ain't gonna call.
What are y'all even saying anymore? I'm telling you, I was in that there dining hall during the blackout.
Wait, what? I say. Okay. Sorry, I've been rewatching Futurama, and that lawyer chat, that lawyer right there. I tell you what, chat right onto the floorboard and said exactly the same. I mean,
where are you from again?
Louisiana.
Ooh, I was born in West Asabu and raised in South Aoyama.
What?
Hey, you guys. A major liar. If Taro was in the dining hall during the blackout, he should have been there after the power returned, right?
Well, I believe so. There's no way he could have gone back and forth in that dark hallway.
Huh? Was Taro actually there during that time?
I feel like they're trying to go.
I sure was. I was there the whole damn time.
That almost sounds like he's going, trying to go like New Orleans with like a weird Jamaican sprinkled in there somewhere. Like this.
Something like this shouldn't be decided by gut instinct. People's lives are at stake.
Damn right. You guys should have been deciding this on the spot with your hazy memories.
His accent is getting even worse. He's definitely lying.
However, I am not sure. I believe that he was there, and I believe that he was not there.
No! Is there any way we can decide?
Why don't we consult his memories?
Consult his memories? Sure, you know what? No, I'm good.
Ah, yeah, don't be saying things like that. Don't make no sense. Can you even prove I wasn't in the dining hall?
There it is. Okay, so we're like going full on like Waterboy. Cajun style, I guess.
I probably can.
Oh, you again!
Whether or not Taro was in the dining hall during the blackout, in order to know for sure, just need to throw that question at him. James, want to attempt that accent? No, sir. As good. Just need to throw that question at him. That question? That one question. No, I don't think that's it. No, even if I ask him about this, I can't corner him with it. Oh, what happened? It's too early for you to say you can't prove
it.
Staring at me, damn it. Okay. Whether or not Taro was in the dining hall during the blackout, in order to know for sure, I just need to throw that question at him. Nurse pig? Well, that was after the fact, wasn't it? During the blackout. Oh no, she did trip. By the time the lights came back on, she ended up in a compromising position.
I can prove it with
this. Oh god,
this.
Yeah, that's it.
If you're claiming that you were in the dining hall when the power came back.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, now that makes more sense.
And you should know how Mikan was positioned at the time, right?
Oh my. He's too pervy not to let this go.
Well, what?
No! Don't make me remember. It's so embarrassing.
No, this is a very important question.
Very weird way,
well,
but...
Well, Taro, if you were really in the dining hall at that time, you should know the answer to that.
Huh?
Try to see the image.
It was a pretty clever way of tripping. There's no way you'd forget about it so easily.
No, I don't think anyone would forget about this. Spread eagle! Wow!
I'm sorry.
Sorry, I didn't even notice the wording there.
I said something so
unsightly. I didn't even notice the words on the side.
How about it? You can't answer, Terateru?
That's weird. Just slipped from my mind.
And there's no way Janet. It would slip from your mind. Especially not a pervert like you.
Even so.
Everyone?
Nagito! Say something!
I guess you might have to give up now.
But he had already figured out who did the murder.
Give up? What do you mean, give up?
Terateru. I'm disappointed too, you know. It's lonely watching someone I admire reach the limits of their hope. It kind of feels like a broken dream.
Nagito, what are you doing? Why are you messing with the killer like that?
Hold on a sec. Don't go moving this along on your own like I really am the killer.
Huh? But it's already decided, right?
The murder weapon hadn't been cleared up yet, Cher?
It's no use. I can't understand him anymore.
Really?
It appears he's saying the murder weapon hasn't been cleared up yet.
I'm wondering, in Japanese, how does this sound? Is it like a completely unintelligible accent?
You understand him?
But it's such a sad defense. This is too cruel.
Oh, if you're calling me the killer, then where's the weapon?
Come on, Manumi. Enough with the whimpering and translate.
He said, if you're calling me the killer,
we really need
then
to translate?
Where's the weapon?
The weapon, huh? It's not the knife, right?
Oh.
Judging from Pyakuya's wounds, it was a thin edged tool that's roughly 5 millimeters in diameter.
Also, if they stabbed from under the floorboards, the weapon would need to be at least 50 centimeters in length.
I gotta admit,
after all this,
the trials in this game are much longer.
About the weapon?
Not good enough! Not good enough at all!
He said, not good enough. Not good enough at all!
Autumn, you don't have to translate.
Let's try thinking about what the weapon was.
That was good, though.
Wanna do it? Wanna do it?
He said, try to do it.
What a confusing accent.
Anyway, we need to focus and think about this. Thin edge tool with a diameter. The weapon that meets this requirements must have been used in the crime scene. Okay, so that was... Wait, do I gotta... No, it's a hangman. All right, skewer? Barbecue skewer? Oh, that is, oh no. I am trying to think. Oh, he had a lot of fun, which is completely fine in my opinion. No, wait a minute. Hang on. What is a... crap. Oh, dear. Oh... Is it bone skewer?